take you back for a minute to your first birthday. It was 20 long years ago, but Chief Dwyer at that time told us that we might be able to get a grant for $387,000. But we had to have a commission for children, youth, and families, and we had that. And so then we had to learn to write a grant, and that was no small trick either. And following that, we got our grant in, and then I started calling different merchants in the community, and I said, would you like to make a donation? And they said, sure. What's your 501c3? And I said, well, I don't have one. And he said, wow, we can't give any money out without 501c3. So, being resourceful, I went to our city attorney, and I said, give me one of those 501c3s. And he said, I not only can't get it for you, you can't have one. And I said, why? And he said, because local units of government are not allowed. And I said, well, can people have them? And he said, yes. And I said, well, I'm a people. Could we have them? And he said, yes. So we found a Dick DeGuano that did a lot of legwork for us and got us a 501c3. So then we started putting the ball together, and I called Gersh Cooper, and I said, I need some front money. And he said, how much? And I said, $5,000. And he said, well, I'm not going to give you $5,000. And I said, oh, I didn't know him. And I said, okay. And he said, I'm going to give you 10. And he pledged 10 every year for 5 years. That's what's a wonderful, wonderful to the community. So here we are, we've got our 501c3. I took it to council, and they were a little bit apprehensive. That grant was for 3 years. How are we going to fund it after that? And I said, I know, just like Mickey Rooney, we'll have a ball. So we decided to have a ball, and we started putting things together. And I didn't know anything about having a ball, but fortunately I knew two friends that did. Debbie Grant and Joanne Smith, they knew how to have a ball. And I could not believe it when we walked in Mercy Center, how it was dazzling, it was wonderful. And that's how our first birthday of the Farmington Hills Council, Farmington Hills Foundation was. And we got, as you know, we got the acceptance from council, and we were off and on our way. And it's in very capable hands now. Although there are a lot of members that are original members, I know for the judge, Marla Parker, Joanne Smith, Chief Dwyer. I'll miss someone, I'm sorry. Why don't you just stand up, the original members of the Arts Class. Okay. And of course, this was all going to fund the after-school program, and you can't say after-school program and not say Todd Lippa. He's absolutely the champion of the Seasonless community. Be prouder of the things he's done. I've seen so many kids prosper just by knowing him, and the work of the foundation has been incredible, and I've enjoyed watching it grow and expand, and I'm so very proud of it, and thank you for this honor.
Nancy, you're very welcome. It's so great to have you here to celebrate our 25th anniversary.